Welcome back to Hot Coffee. We're talking with Senator Judge Jinggoy Estrada. Lots of questions from Twitter and Facebook. Adnan Alonto asks, sa tingin niyo ba yung trial by publicity ng prosecution meron ng epekto sa inyong mga senator judges?
If I were to be asked, wala epekto sa akin yan.
Okay.
Because I would like to listen, to hear, or to appreciate the pieces of evidence inside the impeachment court, not outside of the impeachment court.
Okay. Now, Roberto Ugadan asks, what do you think of Congressman Tupas's answer last Thursday on the alleged corona properties? Sa'yo to.
Yung tinanong mo.
At ang tingin ng ilan, nagsinungaling or hindi sinabi ang totoo.
We'll just let the people judge. I mean, if I were to be asked, I think it was inaccurate in his statements.
Mm-mm. Now, what would your advice be to the prosecution, really?
Well,
You are not anti or pro any right now.
I would like to clarify my stand. I am not defending, as I've said in my when I stood up in the impeachment court, I am not defending the Chief Justice.
Mm-mm.
In fact, I believe he was one of those who conspired to oust my father because of his closeness with the former president Gloria Macapagal Arroyo. What I'm trying to say, or what I'm trying to suggest to the prosecution panel, ano ba? I mean, gawin nyo nang yung trabaho ninyo. I mean, kung ito lang ang representer nyo, you're inviting defeat in the jaws of victory.
And what's hard is, if the prosecution panel is bad and Corona is convicted, it looks bad for the court. The credibility of the court loses.
Correct.
You understand?
Yes.
People will think there was horse trading, lobbying from Malacanang. It doesn't look good. IBP told me that. The IBP said, Karen, it's crucial for the prosecution to perform well so that if he's convicted or acquitted, you know the prosecution did well.
That's why give us, present to the court more evidence for us to decide if we have to convict the Chief Justice. Pag-presente pa sila ng maraming ebidensya.
Okay. Johnny Keats asks, it seems the senator judges are hard on the prosecution. Are they going to do the same to the defense?
Well, we will have to listen first to the defense before we will decide on what questions to ask.
Now, is Senate President Enrile hard on the prosecution? I mean,
no.
You look at the prosecutor, that poor guy. He could, that's the first time he did well. Attorney Perez, if I remember.
Yeah.
The second young one. The second day, he was getting lessons.
Yeah. Actually, the Senate President, he was actually aiding already the prosecution in asking questions to their own witnesses.
Okay.
Tinutulungan na nga ni Manong Johnny yung mga members of the prosecution panel in asking the right questions to their own witnesses. Kasi sometimes, they tend to impeach their own witness.
Yeah.
Bawal yun.
Uh-oh.
Unless they declare him or they declare their own witness as a hostile witness.
Yeah, like the Mega World SVP was a prosecution witness, but everything he said favored the defense.
Yes, I think that was... The bald one. So
yeah.
They did not confer with him before the start of the trial.
Now, could they have said, may we request for a break? We would like to confer with our witness for a few minutes. Is that possible?
Well, I think the defense will not allow it.
I see.
Inside the courtroom, no. The defense will not allow it.
Okay. All right. Dennis Cleofe asks, bilang anak ng dating Pangulo na dumaan sa ganitong proseso, sa tingin niyo po, ano ang maganda at di magandang epekto nitong impeachment trial sa ating bansa, particular sa ekonomiya, hudikatura at demokrasya?
Nakita niyo naman nung impeachment trial ng dating Pangulong Estrada, hindi natapos yan. Dahil nag-walk out yung mga prosecutors because of that controversial second envelope that changed the political landscape in our country.
They walked out, senator judges cried,
some of them,
and got re-elected.
Well, that changed the political landscape in our country.
Yeah,
if that second envelope was subsequently opened he should have been acquitted.
Okay.
At wala tayong gloria makapag-al-aroyo na nagduduo sa mga ang taong bayan ng 9 taon.
Okay.
And I think the 11 senators who voted not to open the envelopes, not to open that second envelope, was proven right.
Oh. Now I want to ask you, I'll be honest, what is the role of or the effect of media? ABS-CBN, The Inquirer, GMA7, Philippine Star, everything, radio, DZMM, on the effect of an impeachment.
During what?
Are you talking? Your dad and now,
during the impeachment trial of my father?
Go ahead.
During the impeachment trial of my father? Well, it was lopsided. It was one-sided in favor of the prosecution. Kasi halos lahat ng batikos, criticisms, lahat ng mga masasamang salita ay sinabi na laban sa tatay ko during the time of the impeachment trial. When you watch, for example, ANC or other networks, medyo bias ng konti.
Because now it seems there's people are more particular with media behavior.
Yes, definitely. It really plays a very, very vital role in the impeachment case of my father and in this present impeachment trial of the Chief Justice.
In fact, Senator, judges are protective of the rights of the respondent now in the media.
Yes.
Yet in really saying, do not release to the media, do not discuss this
correct.
In the media.
He's trying to be fair. He's really very, 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 very fair. In all honesty, that's why I cannot imagine the Senate President. I cannot imagine Senate President Enrile not presiding over the impeachment trial.
Now there was a question here on Twitter: if Senator Enrile is absent, are you going to take over his job as presiding officer? Ito, meron dito.
You know, under our rules, yung rules namin sa Senate.
Ayun si Tofi.
Procedure.
Ikaw ba papalit daw kapag absent?
Alam mo, sa rules and procedures impeachment court, wala naman sinasabi.
Na wala.
Nothing has been stated that the Senate President pro tempore will substitute for the Senate President in case he gets sick or he is not feeling well. Would it only applies to our legislative sessions.
No, but would you want to do that? That's a very tough act to follow, though.
No. I don't want to be presiding there during the impeachment trial. Because first of all,
he's changed the standard.
Yes, first of all, I am not a lawyer.
Okay.
And if I will have to take up the challenge of sitting down there or sitting down in that rostrum, presiding in the impeachment trial, yung 4 na oras namin hearing every day, magiging 8 oras yun, magiging 10 oras yun. Dahil first of all, I cannot just give rulings left and right.
Yeah.
I cannot give, hey, sustained, hey, overruled.
Yeah.
I have to throw it to the body because I'm not a lawyer.
Correct.
Unlike Senator Enrile, Senate President Enrile, he can give rulings left and right because he knows, he understands, because he is a very, very brilliant lawyer.
Actually, the complication starts when Cuevas starts to object relentlessly, yes. And then you now really go into the practice of law.
Correct.
Oo.
Memoryado nila yung rules on evidence.
Yeah.
Rules of court. Oh, ako naman, di ko naman memoryado yun. Because I am not a lawyer.
Now, is it a factor that some senator judges are not lawyers? I mean, in terms of judgment.
Well, we non-lawyers, we have to read more than what the lawyers are doing right now. No? During the break, I have been reading the articles of impeachment, the rules of court, the rules of evidence, talagang binabasa ko. I would want to refresh what I've studied before when I took up law.
Yeah.
That was 15 years ago.
Can I be candid? I'll just be candid. People have a bad impression. Not all, majority, have a bad impression of actors in public office. Okay? I mean, I think you know this.
Yes.
In the Senate, I mean, when Senator Lito Lapid spoke for the first time, it was like the $60,000 question. Ang mahal. I mean, you know, they have a bad image of actors. They feel, di naman nag-aral, nandun lang yan dahil popular, wala namang alam yan. But you've really impressed a lot of people, even in the Senate Blue Ribbon Committee.
Hindi naman not all actors are bad.
That's it, go ahead.
No, not all actors are bad. A lot of actors have been successful in their political career. Mm. No? Yung nga, tatay ko, naging presidente. Kasi there is this impression na walang mga tinapos yung mga artista.
Or walang alam yung ilan.
Walang alam yung ilan. Siguro meron mga ilan-ilan. Oh, pero hindi naman lahat ng mga artista eh walang alam.
Oo.
That's
a bias.
A bias interpretation or perception of actors. I don't really believe in that.
But are you more pressured? You? To yes. read more and study more because you are a former and are an actor.
Yes, definitely. I don't want people to say, oh, anak lang ni Erap yan. Oh, artista lang yan. Kasi only few people know that I finished my studies and I took up law.
Oh, nag-law ka. Did you finish law?
No.
But you did not.
Yeah. I was in the College of Law for 4 years.
Okay. And oh my God, that's a lot.
Yeah. I had only one semester to go. And I stopped studying because I ran for mayor in San Juan.
Okay, all right.
So, sometimes nagsisisi ako kasi my dad really wanted me to become a lawyer.
Okay.
And right now, he's always telling me, kung sinunod mo ako dati, sana abogado ka na, sana nakaka-cope up ka dyan sa impeachment trial. Matigas ang ulo ko. Matigas ang ulo.
Are you close to your dad?
Yes, I'm close to my parents, of course.
You are. Is it hard to follow in your father's footsteps?
Definitely.
Yes,
first of all, I do not have his charisma. Mas maganda lalaki sa akin. And of course, he gladly admits that. No? And first, secondly, he's done a lot for our country. Naging mayor, senator, vice president, and president. Ako hanggang senator lang, so... Mahirap pantayan yung kanyang mga achievements.
Okay, your reaction. Filipino-Chinese businessmen are worried that opening Corona's bank accounts could result in a bank run.
Very possible.
Okay.
Like what happened during the impeachment trial of my father.
Uh-oh.
When they presented the bank accounts, nag-bank run yung Equitable.
Uh-oh. No, and your father sued, was it Citibank?
Citibank. For voluntarily giving... or presenting the documents in the impeachment court.
Uh-oh. Because bank accounts, whether we like it or not, even if you're a public official, have to be subpoenaed.
Correct.
They are private, confidential.
Correct.
Okay.
Yes, that is correct. But under the law, sa AMLA, yung mga peso accounts, once subpoenaed by the court, or any court for that matter, can be subpoenaed.
I see. Okay. On President Arroyo, the COMELEC says she can remain in the hospital during the trial. What's your stand?
Well, I agree. Just let her stay in Veterans Memorial.
That's what your father wants
hospital.
Too. No?
First of all, I echo the same sentiment of that of my father, that she is a woman. Kalimutan na natin naging presidente siya. Pero babae yun, kailangan natin galangin. Let her stay in the hospital.
Uh-oh.
Huwag naman natin siyang ilagay sa rehas. Hindi naman magandang tingnan yan.
Why do you have these thoughts? People would think differently.
Regarding?
Yeah, regarding Mrs. Arroyo.
Well, you know, I've learned a lot from my father. He has a forgiving heart. No? Kahit inagawan siya ng pwesto, kinulong pa kami. At the end of the day, he has forgiven a lot of people who betrayed him. You know, like, for example, Ms. Arroyo, Chavit Singson, the late Secretary Angie Reyes.
Uh-huh.
All those went to, all of them, except for Chavit, all of them, and except for Gloria, all of them went to Tanay to visit my father.
Yeah.
Even Senator Villar.
Mm. Oh, really?
Yeah, Vice President, I think it was Vice President, former Vice President Gingona, who went to Tanay.
Okay.
Although they did not apologize.
Yes, but they visited.
Yeah, they visited former President Estrada.
Now, here's a light moment. Huh? Your dad said, my EP is telling me now, on Liamas, hindi naman daw nagnakaw si Liamas, bumili lang ng pirated DVD.
Well, you know, I asked my dad about it. Did you say that hindi naman nagnakaw yan, pero bumili? Because, you know, my father is from the movie industry.
Yeah, poor Ronnie Ricketts. Yeah. Good God,
no, but
OMG.
You know what he told me?
What?
No, he was buying a foreign film, a pirated foreign film, not a local film.
Okay, but if I were going to ask you, do you think Liamas, well, they said he offered to resign.
Yes.
You think the president should have let him go?
Well, I don't think so. Eh, kung talagang katiwala niya si Mr. Liamas, so it's better if he would have, yeah, he retained him, so okay lang yan. Walang problema.
All right, a showbiz question. Please ask the good senator from Pretanglao. Did you ever court Miss Chris Aquino? Did you? Ganto palang angulo.
Gagalit asawa ko niyan eh, pero...
Oo. Hindi, secure na yun. Secure na yung asawa mo.
Dati, before. Hindi naman courting eh. Umiepa lang.
Are you serious?
Umiepa lang before.
Really?
when her mom was still the president. Yeah.
And that was really young. That's like 1986.
Yeah. I think so.
Oh. But a lot of people have also noticed you lost a lot of weight. Do you want to share the secret?
Huh? It's the first time that I'm going to share the secret.
No, really. No, you look really slim.
Well, I had this surgery 3 years ago. It's called the bariatric surgery.
Okay. Why did you do that?
Because I can't control my eating habits already.
Yes, yes. Then you lost a lot of weight.
I lost around 40 to 50 pounds.
Wow. Okay, and it's effective.
Very effective.
Do you feel healthier?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I eat a small amount, but more frequent.
More frequent, yes. Yeah. All right. Now, more questions. Do you know how many questions came in for you? Like 200 plus.
Really?
Yes, right now. Okay. All right. Ignacio Jade, I'm impressed. Senator Estrada is good. He's working for, he worked for the respect of the people. Magaling. Meaning to gain the respect of the people. All right. Let's move on. There are more questions coming in. EJ Arceo, how would he convince the public that his decision will not be biased?
Well, it all depends on the evidence that are going to be presented by the prosecution. Time and again, I said, even though Chief Justice Corona was one of those who conspired against my father, that is water under the bridge already. I will not take it against him. I will base my decision solely on the evidence presented.
Okay. Anthony is asking, will you tell your colleagues to screen their question and follow the rules of court?
I cannot do that because... each one of us has our own independent minds.
Okay. Eric Bonifacio, factor ba sa magiging decision mo sa voting ang pagiging magkapartido nyo ni JPE? Well, it's a great question.
Well, in fairness to JPE, who is head of our block, I belong to JPE's block. He never, ever influenced me on what vote will I make.
Okay. Earliest Factor is asking, can you ask Senator Jinggoy, is the testimony of BIR Commissioner still material?
Well, she has to be cross-examined by the defense this afternoon.
Mm-mm.
Yes, it is still material.
Okay.
I
All right.
So.
We ran out of time, but one last. What's this? What's your take on your father? Harley's asking that he's running for mayor of Manila.
Well, he's still undecided.
Okay. Mm.
Mm-mm. He just might or might not.
Okay. All right. Last word, sir.
Well, I would like to assure our people, the Filipino people, that I will base my decision on the evidence presented. And I would like to call on our people to be vigilant and to always follow the proceedings in the impeachment trial of Chief Justice Renato Corona.
Okay. All right. Thank you very much, Senator Judge Jinggoy Estrada. That's Head Start today. I'm Karen Davila. Have a good day, everyone. I'll see you again tomorrow. Impeachment trial coverage at 1 o'clock this afternoon on ANC.